Today, we give a quick overview on how we create furniture designs in FreeCAD. FreeCAD is an open source software that is mainly geared towards mechanical engineers. In this video, we cover how to create parametric designs, integrate cost and supplier information into your CAD model, assemble a piece of furniture, create a cut list, a drawing, as well as a nice rendering for a piece of furniture. As an example, we use this Japanese toolbox design we use in a variety of sizes. The big advantage of FreeCAD is that it is fully parametric and you can change dimensions after finishing the design. We only have to change the parameters in the spreadsheet and the box becomes square. The first step is to create this spreadsheet with all the dimensions. For the box, these are the material thickness as well as the inner width, length and height. We use a macro to create aliases for these numbers so that we can refer to them by name later. The macro and all other resources are linked on the detailed website article. The link to this article is in the description below. After having saved the file with the spreadsheet under the name master, comes the part that is quite cumbersome. We create a new file for each individual board. In the part workbench, we add a cube. To enter a formula for the dimensions, we click the blue circle. This cube gets the dimensions from the spreadsheet in the format file name, hashtag, table name, dot, variable name. This would be, for example, master hashtag p dot material. You can also perform calculations when entering the dimensions, e.g. adding 4 times the material thickness to the overall length. After creating all the files following the same schema, we make sure the Assembly 2 plus workbench is installed. Go to Tools, Add-on Manager and install the latest version. Also make sure that in Edit Preferences A2 plus, the checkboxes for Recalculate Imported Parts before updating them and Use Experimental Topology Naming are enabled. For the cut list functionality we will discuss later, you have to change 2 files of this add-on. Instructions about these modifications can also be found on our website. After switching to the A2 plus workbench, we can now import the individual parts one by one with the button that shows a plus sign. These parts can be aligned with one another in a variety of ways. For woodworking projects, most of the assemblies can be solved by making planes coincident. Just select 2 faces that you want to align, click on the plane coincidence button, and decide if the 2 objects are opposed or aligned with one another. After aligning 3 faces, a board is locked in place. Assembling a project this way is fast and actually quite fun. After everything is assembled, we can easily create a cut list with the part list button. If the dimensions are not listed for you, you have to modify the A2 plus workbench as described on the website. After importing the cut list in LibreOffice, it is easy to calculate square footage, price, weight and other data. You can also export the data to another software, such as Cut List Optimizer, a free optimization program that helps you to optimize sheet good usage. When using hardware such as hinges or knobs for a project, you can add information about a part directly in the cut file. Just select the Part Info button from the Assembly 2 workbench and you can add various information. All this information will at the end show up in the part list and make cost calculations and ordering parts easy and convenient. Besides the cut list, a drawing is quite helpful when building the final piece. In the Tech Draw workbench, we create a new drawing and are now free to insert different views. We can also select only part of the assembly, for example the lid, and generate a drawing for only these elements. We scale them and add measurements that will help us later when assembling the parts. Sometimes it's nice to get a better visualization than what the CAD application can offer. With a few clicks, we change to the ray tracing workbench and add a new PovRay project and add our objects to that rendering. With the default settings, the rendering looks bad, as it is missing any texture. On our website, we describe in detail how to use different template files and how to fine-tune the results so that it looks like in this picture. This provides already a nice visualization on how the final result could look like. Overall, FreeCAD is not the ideal software for woodworking, but it is open source and you can modify everything and add new features yourself. We like to test new ways of working with wood, be it in software or in the workshop. Maybe you also give FreeCAD a try. If you are interested in more woodworking and making videos, please subscribe and follow us on Instagram for a look at future projects.